يعتقد شخص أن غير الله يخلق أو يرزق أو يحيي أو يميت إلى غير ذلك من صفات الربوبية. He say like a person believing in his heart that there is other than Allah that creates, that other than Allah is the provider, that other than Allah is the giver of life, that other than Allah is the one that take life, or any of those issues or the description of the rububiyyah. So if we want to make it all easy, we will say, ascribing Allah in these three things of the matters of rububiyyah: al-khalq, al-mulk, wa-tadbir. So any of these three, and when we say these three things, it is a lot of ramification of it. Right? A lot of things branch out from these three things. So this is the basis. The foundations of rububiyyah. Man, but it means that you have many things that branch out from it. Let's say giving of life. Right? Let's say the creation, the ownership, giving life, giving rizq. You got many things that barakallah branch off from these three things of our rububiyyah. Al-khalq, creation. Al-mulk, ownership. And at-tadbir, disposing the affairs. So he say, وَذَلِكَ It is like أن يعتقد شخص, an individual, he believes in أن غير الله يخلق, that other than Allah creates. That other than Allah creates. أو يرزق, or he can provide. Some people, they believe that other people can provide. Some people, they believe they some other people can provide. Or yuhi, they can give life or cause death. It's all up to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So nobody is to be a scribe, partner with Allah in these matters. Nobody. You should never fear a person too so much that you think that he can be taking your life. Because taking life is only from Allah. Because if you fear that this individual, he's the only one that can take my life, then that could fall into what? Shirkul rububiyyah. How many times you hear a person, barakallahu fikum, was, subhanallah, yani, flooded with gunshot and still alive? Right? Flooded with gunshot, barakallahu fikum, sprayed with bullets. But barakallah, he might be sitting in our mix, barakallah feek. How many times a person, subhanallah, had a wreck, a car accident, to the point that if they would have tell you somebody survived from this, you won't believe it. The man will get up and just, you know, kind of dust off his shirt and keep it moving. Nothing happened to him. That shows that barakah, taking life and death is only from Allah. Only from Allah. You have individual, they will give you some type of amulets. They will tell you if you wear it, you won't die. Believe me, they say that. You put those on your, you either eat it or you put it on. I don't know what I'm talking about. Huh? How y'all call it? Huh? No, there is a name for that. We call it tul. Meaning you will not know if somebody stab you. Okay, yes. Balando, right? And you got people, barakallah, it's something that they... And this is all about the jinn, invoking the jinn. Because once the person tired, the minute... And barakallah, by the way, that alhamdulillah, from our belief is to believe that the jinn, they are very fast. They can travel a distance and easily. So anytime that a person, barakallahu fikum, is being, a gun or a knife is being raised to, you know, up to him, then the jinn will be a shield right there. Whether the gun will not will be, what you call that? The gun will jam, or if the shot is made, it's not gonna affect the individual. Now this is reality, though. Don't think this is like what you call those you know those things that they wear now. Virtual reality. This is a reality, but it's not virtual reality. It is reality. Because they utilize the jinn for those things. But guess what? Before they have that, they have to do what? Sacrifice for the jinn. And we will come to that one of those types of shirk. See how this one is important? Shirk fi rububiyyah, to understand it. Because shirk fi rububiyyah will lead to shirk fi uluhiyyah. And this is, barakallahu feekum, that which is to be avoided. Na'am. I mean, as a matter of fact, though, let's say, I will say in for instance, in Senegal, what really had developed, what had brought out what had brought out this magic stuff, is the wrestling. What brought it out, like, you know, now people are brave with it, that they do voodoo, they do black magic. Brave about it is this wrestling. Akhi, this individual, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. If certain things that you know that they do, that can make you vomit. That can make you sick. Akhi, think about it. You take the menses of a woman and you write Surah Mulk on it, with it. And the wrestler will put it in his private. The wrestler will put it in his underwear. Yeah, sure. You can't. You might be falling from the sky right now, right? The menses of a woman. They will write some of, and when they write it, they will put it upside down. And we write it, they will write the Fatiha upside down, right? And the Fatiha, what's the last word in Fatiha? Ahmed, the last word in Fatiha. What's the last in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah ar-Rahman. What's the last word? Let him think, please. The last thing, the last word in Fatiha. Just recite in your mind until the last one. Before Amin, what comes before Amin? Walad Dalin, barakallah, ma'am. Walad Dalin. So they will take from Walad Dalin, and the Dalin, the noon is the N, right? So they will start with the noon. Before the noon, what you have? Ya. Right? You will have the ya. You say the ya? Barakallah, fiqh Muhammad. You have the ya. Ahsanta, good job. You have the ya, right? Walad Dal, and you have the lamb. So this is where they have started. The noon, the ya, the lamb, so and so forth and so on, until they go by the alif with the ba from the bismillah. And they will write this down with some of them with menses, and they will put it in their underwear. Wal'iyadhu billah. These are truly the people that wal'iyadhu billah had made these issues of magic to be something that is at another level now. There is no day that you hear the news or the media or you read the on the internet except you will find people coming out saying things like this, wal'iyadhu billah, calling others to that, promoting themselves. And what is sad in this is the same wrestlers, they go to the big Sufi sheikhs, the imams and the likes, for them to also seek prayer from them. And those individuals won't say that this is haram. They won't say that. Because also they find themselves in some type of, it add to their status. Because this is the most brilliant wrestler in town. That's my disciple. That is adding to him. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala aid us and allow us to be among those whom Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will bless to be fighting these issues. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallama ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So we had tonight the first type, which is shirk fi rububiyya. Wa sallallahu wa sallama ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Hayakum Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallama ala Muhammad. Subhanak Allah wa rabbana hamashir. No. We'll come to that, inshallah. But ma'ana shirk is part of it. Still part of it.
No, Barakallah, that's very good. It's good. It's good. I'm going to write it down. So.
Buy some cards.
I have a suit.